Maria. That is so, so surreal. Like, how are we above all those people? So, that song was, we had a writing camp where we got like loads of really cool writers and really talented producers, and we just sat down and wrote loads of songs, and Living Too Well was one of those songs that came out, and it was one that came out that week of writing, and it was, you know, the song, I think, is very, you know, relatable to our band, you know, because it's all about, you know, being in a relationship that's ended, but, you know, you're saying you find that it's ended, but the person you've ended it with knows you too well, and I think that's what kind of so real about a relationship is that, so, and also, like, it has, like, that kind of Spanish, Latino vibe. We've never done a song in that kind of vein before, so I think it was really cool to then get Dana, who's so talented, to sing on the song and do the Spanish verse, because it just gave it that extra, you know, that extra edge. You know, a place so far away from home is so crazy to us. You know, we're just literally, you know, boys from little towns in England. So to have our album and songs doing so well is unreal. We
just want to see how far it can go. It's already way past our expectations, like, from the start. But now that our fans are so supportive and online, it's so crazy. We just want to see how far it can go. You know, we might even be able to get a top 10 album, which would just be absolutely crazy for a day, you know, like, our debut album, and to get that far up the charts would be incredible in the UK. But to be honest, we just, you know, this is just the start. We're going to release this album, and then we're going to tour the album. We're going to work on new music, new singles, bigger tours. You know, we just want to keep doing it for as long as possible, because it's our favorite thing to do. We're loving it.
100, of course. I mean, it's our first album, so it's, you know, it's just, we're so satisfied with it. I mean, it's been, like Reese just said, it's been 3.5 years in the making, so we knew what we were, you know, what we were waiting for. It wasn't like we were just holding it back. We just wanted to make sure we were really happy with the first piece of full work we're giving to everyone. So, of course, I mean, I think I'd say 100.
Stop repeating in my house. All my friends are playing it in the car. It's so funny because, you know, like, I'll be in the. We just went home for the first time in a while, and I, like, all my friends were coming to visit me, and we're pulling up in the cars with our own album blasting, which is, like, it's so funny. But they're all so proud, you know, they've seen how hard we've worked behind the scenes, and they've seen how much of our life we put into this. So it's really a big moment for us and for them. Dearest is one of the first songs that we wrote on our LA trip. So when we were younger, we used to go to LA, and we'd literally go on like a month long ride trip where we'd be staying three in a room, and we'd every day, kind of like school, like 12 o'clock, we'd go straight to our writing session, and then around 6 we'd finish and get food. And it was really funny. It was almost like a school trip every time we went. But serious, I think it was at a time when we were just really young, and you know, a couple of us had relationships, and we felt like we just wanted to be free, and we just wanted nothing serious, and to be able to just live our lives and be young. And it came at a time where we were felt a bit trapped and not able to experience things properly. Well, the last time we were there was when we played our biggest show to date, and, you know, coming out to a crowd that, you know, sold out, that, you know, so many people want to come and see us live. Like I said earlier, to be so far away from home and having people want to come and watch us live and sing songs that aren't in their native language is unreal. It's something that, you know, will never take for granted, and always be so so appreciative of. And yeah, so to come out to a crowd like that was singing and screaming so loud for us, it was just like mind-boggling. Yeah, they're honestly crazy. Korea's one of our favorite places to go.
The first time we turned up it was literally insane to us because we didn't think anybody knew who we were. And we turned up at the airport and there everybody is with on masks and like, it was just crazy. Like, and ever since then, you know, our two sold out shows and the show we did last year, which was just huge. It's just been honestly insane, and we're so appreciative of the support that we get from Korean fans. We see it every day, all day on online. The things that they do for us, and their art, and they're just really lovely people, and they all seem quite wholesome. The fans in Korea, which is very nice. And yeah, we're always looking forward to our next trip to Korea.
Well, we go into rehearsals in next month for a little bit. We have like a week or so just to get the show down. It's going to be, you know, obviously the album's out, so there's new music to play and there's, you know, new songs to develop, and, you know, some of the old songs I'm sure we'll play slightly differently. And so we'll just work on making the songs, you know, sound good, and, you know, we'll get the performance down and just hope that they enjoy it as much as us, because when we go on stage in Korea that we always have such an amazing time, so we'll just make sure that they have as good of a time as we are having. We actually usually have pretty much full control of what we're doing. No one tells us like they want the show to be like this or anything like that. It's literally the three of us. We sit down in rehearsals and we talk about how we want to do it. So you'll see it. You'll see the show. That'll be our 100% input. We'll have George flying out of a cannonball shooter and fly across the crowd on a rope swing and, you know, land in the middle of the crowd while I'm dressed up in a funny costume and Reese is just standing there playing bass. No, not at all. We always want to help each other out, if anything. You know, we want to... The thing is, we're a team, and we, you know, we always want to play a part in helping each other and making sure everyone's good and happy. So there's no competition unless we're playing FIFA.
Yeah, I agree. Yeah, we promise that we don't fight over anything other than FIFA.
We come back soon. We do miss you a lot. You're our favourite.
Sarangye.
No more Bobushi Dog Korea.
Annyeong. Sarangye. We miss you so much. Thank you for all the support we see online. We don't forget you. We could not. Thank you so much. We'll see you very soon. And we're going to have a killer show. Bigger and better than last time. We'll see you soon. Love you.